everyone. Welcome back to Time Traveling Treasures. If you are returning, welcome back. I haven't posted in a while, so it is great to be back doing videos again. I last left off, my last video was a before and after office renovation. I had the before, but not the after. So that's what this video is. I'm going to show you the after and take a little bit of time to explain to you, number one, what all happened, number two, why it's taken so long for me to get back with you guys. So we started with the wallpaper. If you have not seen that video, I will link it and you can go and see it. I highly suggest it. But Cliff Notes version, there's a lot of green wallpaper, some crazy 80s curtains, a lot of wood things, and it was very outdated and not practical for what I needed for my reseller business. So now it is much, much nicer. It is beautiful. I love it. It is highly functional and it's my favorite place in the house to be. The reason why it has taken so long for me to get this video going is because as I was setting up my inventory system, which is back here behind me, as I was setting up my inventory system, I was noticing as I went to renew the listings with the box ID for the item, I was noticing that some of the items just weren't even listed anymore. I'm talking probably about maybe 50 or more items just weren't even listed on eBay. So I had to go through, relist everything, reorganize everything. Basically, it was like starting from scratch, minus what I already had pictures of, which I'm glad those were still there. So I'm not really sure what happened within eBay that my listings just kind of disappeared. If I had to guess, I would say it was when everything was transitioning over from when they automatically relisted it for you to when they didn't relist it. Maybe things kind of slipped through. But now I have everything in its home. Everything is listed. Everything is good to go. And I'm excited to be able to get back to doing my videos. So, without further ado, I'm going to hop to the tour of the new room and I will check back with you after the tour and follow up and do a little finish up with you. So I will be right back. So we'll start with the door and entering into the room. We picked an off-white color to go with the white walls so that it wasn't just so washed out white. It looks a little darker here than it actually is. And yes, I know we need hardware, it's coming. I'd like to put a tall desk here or just a tall work table to do shipping. I don't really have an established place to do shipping, and it'd be a benefit to have it there because in this closet is my shipping supplies and also a portal back in time to the green wallpaper. It's like Narnia, but green. So I have all of my supplies here. It's quite a mess. Boxes are everywhere. I would like to put shelving in here so that I can store them and be able to find them quickly. This has been wonderful. I took the closet rod and I put my craft paper on it. And then I usually have my bubble wrap right there, but it is currently missing in action from the delivery that I just ordered. So hopefully it'll get here soon because I only have that amount right there. That blue thing is all the bubble wrap that I have. So hopefully it'll get here soon. But for now, we're just gonna close the closet. Let this go back, hide it away, which is why I love it being in there. And then we'll focus our attention to what replaced all of the stuff that I put in there. That's right, it's the death pile. So in the resale world, we call this the death pile because it's the place where things go and you just forget about them. But actually, it's not too bad because this is stuff that I've purchased recently This is stuff that's going to be in the upcoming thrift haul video. Don't worry, it's not going to be all of it, but I am going to pick out some of the more recent things. This is where I do my photographing for my listings, so things will kind of be staged to the right. I'll take the pictures and the light box in the middle, and then I write down the information. I'll use the tape measure, take the measurements, write everything down so that way when I'm doing the listing, I can remember key points. And then I usually put the items right there just to kind of stage them out of the way. That's just my stuff. It's just stuff that I use to help with either shipping or listings. That's my toolbox where I have my tape and my alcohol, my scale, and my printer. And these are the curtains. I love these curtains. They really make this place look great. It took a while for them to get here, but we got them. And then the curtain rod, we got them. That's what's important. It's here. We took the hutch off of the desk, which is great because it opened it up and it allowed us to put it in the corner and still have access to the window. So we're allowing a lot of light in. We had really heavy wooden blinds on and it didn't provide a lot of light. So this is a better look at what the curtains look like. I love the little wavy pattern. It kind of looks like a time traveling theme. And then when the light hits it, it kind of sparkles a little bit. So I love the curtains and the amount of light that it lets in. So here's the inventory. This is what I've been doing for the past few months, is I've been putting everything in the boxes and getting everything organized. And as you can see, I'm using the alphabet system where if I have something listed, I have down what box it's in. As you can also see, the K and the L have gotten mixed up. For those people that are bothered by it like I was, trust me, it's been fixed. I have all my mugs in that cup. That's the system I used to use. I was going to have like mugs in one box and plates in another box. And then I just decided that was just a waste of space. So I went ahead and just used a different system. The big box is on the bottom. I have a holiday box, a box with books and papers, and a toy box. This is a staging area that I have. So after I've listed it, I put it there to be put into the inventory boxes. So there it is. That's the room. That's the renovation. As you can see, it was quite a difference, quite a big change, and I absolutely love it. And it is so functional, and I just love being in here. It's just so much brighter and lighter. And now that all the inventory straightened out, it's really helped my productivity as well. So I have been doing thrifting. In fact, I have, as you saw in the video, there's a stack of stuff that I still have to get listed, whether you call it a death pile or a source spot. I don't know what you call it, but I have quite a big one. So I used to do thrifting maybe 3 times a week, and since the pandemic has come out, I've kind of limited my time out in town. So now I go maybe once, sometimes twice a week, and very limited. But I do want to do some more thrift with me videos. So look forward to that. And also look forward to the thrift haul video that I'll probably be putting out tomorrow. So thank you so much for taking the time to tour my office, and I hope to see you again soon. Bye.